Let us bow down our heads and look unto the Lord in prayer. Dear Lord, our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this wonderful day that you've given to us, Lord. You've been so kind enough to take care for everything that we have to do this day, Lord. Father, we commit this consecration service into your hands. Lord, we want you to be present and lead the service for us, Lord. We want you to chair this special service for us. We want you to guide us in the special service. We want you to move your Holy Spirit in the special service. We want you that you may help us and give us the wisdom. And especially today, as the bishop is consecrated for the Diocese of North America, we present him in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us join together. Let us rise up and join together to sing the hymn number 1. Praise my soul, the King of Heaven. God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be glory in the Church and in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Blessed Lord and Father, we have assembled in your name and in fellowship with one another. Enable us by your grace to offer the sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, to proclaim and respond to your holy word. Teach us to pray for your world and your church. Grant that we, confessing our sins, may verbally offer to you our souls and bodies as a living sacrifice, and eat and drink of your spiritual food in this holy sacrament. Amen.
Thank you. God, may clean our hearts within us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the Eternal Father, through your Holy Spirit, we have appointed many ministries in the church. Bless your servant, Andrew Sagayam, now called to be a bishop, and maintain him in your truth, renew him in your holiness, and make him your ever faithful servant, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Please be seated. The word of the Lord be read.
For thus saith the Lord God, behold, I, even I, will both search my sheep and seek them out. As a shepherd seeketh out his flock in the day, that he is among the sheep that are scattered, so will I seek out my sheep, and deliver them out of all places where they have been scattered in the cloudy and dark day. And I will bring them out from the people, and gather them from the country, and will bring them to their own land, feed them upon the mountains of Israel, by the rivers, and in the inhabited places of the country. I will feed them in a good pasture, and upon the high mountains of Israel shall their fold be. There shall they lie in a good fold, and in a fat pasture shall they feed upon the mountains of Israel. I will feed my flock, and I will cause them to lie down, saith the Lord God. I will seek that which was lost, and bring again that which was driven away, and will bind up that which was broken, and will strengthen that which was sick. But I will destroy the fat and the strong. I will feed them with judgment. And as for you, O my flock, thus saith the Lord God, behold, I judge between cattle and cattle, between the rams and the eagles. See, look at the small thing unto you have eaten up the good pasture, but ye must tread down with your feet the residue of your pasture, and you have drunk of the deep waters, but he must call the residue with your feet. Driven away, and will bind up that which was broken, and will strengthen that which was sick. But I will destroy the fat and the strong. I will feed them with judgment. And as for you, O my flock, thus saith the Lord God, behold, I judge between cattle and cattle, between the rams and the eagles. See, look at the small thing unto you have eaten up the good pasture, but ye must tread down with your feet the residue of your pasture, and you have drunk of the deep waters, but he must call the residue with your feet. And for my flock, they eat that which he has called with your feet, and that which he has called with your feet. Therefore thus saith the Lord God unto them, behold, I, even I, will judge between the fat cattle and between the lean cattle. Because ye have crushed his side and his shoulder, and put all the disease with your thorns, till ye have scattered them abroad. Therefore will I save my flock, and they shall no more be afraid. And I will judge between cattle and cattle. And I will set up one shepherd over them, and he shall feed them. Even my servant David, he shall feed them, and he shall be their shepherd. And I, the Lord, will be their God, and my servant David, a prince among them. I, the Lord, have spoken it. Here endeth the reading of the first lesson.
The husband of one wife, vigilant and sober of good behavior, given to hospitality and apt to teach, not given to wine, no striker, not greedy of filthy liquor and bictian, not a brawler, nor covetous. One that ruleth well his own house, having his children in subjection with all gravity. For if man know not how to rule his own house, how shall he take care of the church of God? Not a noise, lest being lifted up with a bribe, he fall into the condemnation of the devil. Moreover, he must have a good report of them which are without lest I fall into reproach and the snare of the devil. Likewise, must a deacon be grave, not a double tongue, not given to much wine, not greedy of filthy liquor, holding the mystery of the faith in pure conscience, and let this also first be proved, and then let them use the office of deacon, being found blameless. The second reading is ended.
The Gospel reading is taken from the book of John, chapter 10, 1 to 14. Book of John, chapter 10, 1 to 14. But if you, he that entered not by the road into the sheepfold, but of the other way, the same is a thief and robber. But he entered in by the door, shepherd of the sheep. To him, the road. And the sheep hears his voice, and he calls his own sheep by name, and leadeth them out before them, and the sheep follow him, for they know his voice. And a stranger will not but they, and the stranger will they not follow, but will flee from him, for they know not the voice of the stranger. This parable spake Jesus unto them, but they understood not what things they were. Which he spoke unto them. Then said Jesus unto them again, Verily, verily, I say unto you, I am the door of the sheep. All that ever come before me are the thieves and robbers. But the sheep did not hear of them. I am the door. By me, if any man enter there, he shall be saved, and shall go in and out and find the pasture. The thief comes out, but not for to steal. And to kill and to destroy. I am come that they might have the life and they might have it with more abundantly. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd gives his life for the sheep. But he that is hireling and not the shepherd whose own sheep are not, sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and flee. And the wolf catches them and scatters them the sheep. The hireling flees because he was hired. And care not for the sheep. I am the good shepherd, and know my sheep, and I know more mine.
I bring greetings from the Anglican Church of South India, especially the inauguration service of the Diocese of North America and the consecration service of Reverend Father Andrew Sagayam, who is going to be the bishop of the North America Diocese. It's a wonderful day today that the Lord has brought us together. As children of God, we have been called to serve and to be served. So we see, as we heard the word of the Lord
from the book of Ezekiel
34 verses 8 to 24, especially in that 16th verse, it's a wonderful verse where it says, I will see that which was lost and bring again that which was driven away, and will bind up that which was broken, and will strengthen that which was sick. But I will destroy the fat and the strong. I will feed them with judgment. This is a wonderful saying of the prophet Ezekiel. And that's a prophecy today for Reverend Father Andrew Sagayam also. For he being to be consecrated as the bishop of the Diocese of North America. It's a wonderful country and it's a wonderful nation where people have been serving the Lord, hearing the word of the Lord, doing the word of the Lord. I always love the American country. The reason is that even though the whole world says the economy is down, but still, till today, America stands the first. There's no one to shake economically, spiritually, and socially. Because I often admire their wonderful money that they have in their hand, the dollars. It's clearly written in the dollars, in God we trust. The dollar says, in God we trust. When the dollar itself says, in God we trust, and the people who use it should be saying the same words, in God we trust, and not on the dollars that they have in their hand. And we Indians, we think, if we do not have money in our hand, if we do not have, we also, in God we trust. So once we trust in God, naturally everything would be on our side in this world. For the word of the Lord says very clearly, seek ye first the kingdom of God, and all the riches of this world would be added unto you. So here we see, I will seek that which was lost. That's what the prophet Ezekiel says over here. It means everything that happens in this world is followed where it has happened in the United States of America. So whatever happens in the United States of America, the whole world follows it. And today, I would give this promised word to my dear son, Andrew Sagayam, saying, the Lord has chosen you to be the bishop of North America Diocese in the Anglican Church of South India to seek that which was lost in the United States of America and whole of North America in Canada also.